guys, my name is Kevin, and welcome to our third and final day of Let's Play Blues Together for the Baritone. In today's lesson, we're going to check out a whole new set of chords in the minor key. So the blues can be played with major, the blues can also be played with minor. There's a couple new chords we need to learn, but everything else is going to be the same. I love the blues in minor, so join me as we finish up here with day three. Hey, before we get started, make sure you hit that like button, subscribe, and click that alert bell so you know when the next video is coming your way. If you're interested in more learning resources, head over to allforuke.com where we have a full searchable library of songs, song sheets, practice tracks, worksheets, and more. All for you, allforuke.com. All right, let's check out the minor chords that we're going to use here today. So today I'm going to show you two versions of each chord so that we can start using a little bit more real estate on the neck here. So the first version, which is our one chord here, is E minor. E minor is easy on the baritone because it's middle finger here, D string of the second fret. And then the second version of that chord is up here on the ninth fret. So I have my ring and pinky on the ninth fret of the D and G string. I have my middle finger on the 8th fret of the B string and my index on the E string of the 7th fret. So that sounds like this. So when we're playing E minor, you'll have a chance to kind of work your way up here, or you could also take your index finger and bar the entire 7th fret as you play this chord. The second chord that we need is our 4 chord. The 4 chord in the minor blues is actually an A minor. I was going to say D minor, but it's actually an A minor. So the A minor chord is middle finger and ring finger on the D and G string of the 2nd fret and index on the B string of the 1st fret. And you can also play that chord up here on the 5th fret if you bar the entire 5th fret and put your ring finger on the D string of the 7th fret. So that sounds like this. This is a good chord to learn how to play. This is a nice A minor up here. And then we have a B minor chord, which is played down here with our ring and pinky on the 4th fret of the D and G strings, middle finger on the B string of the 3rd fret, and index on the E string of the 2nd fret. And our secondary shape for this is up here by barring the 7th fret with our index finger and putting our ring finger here on the 9th fret of the D string. So this is pretty cool. We have E minor, A minor, and B minor. The one little in-between chord that we'll need today when we start doing the walk down is our B flat minor. So all we need to do the B flat minor for the walk down is take this B minor chord and move it down a fret so that we're on the 3rd fret with the exact same shape that we used here for A minor, B flat minor, B minor. So pretty cool little walk down there. And then if we were to try to do that up in the high position, if we were playing B minor up here on the 7th fret, we would walk down to the 6th fret for the B flat minor, and then down to our A minor. So two different sounding little walk downs there, using same chords. So you get a little extra room here to use on your neck, which is awesome on the baritone. So those are the chords we're going to need, the 1, the 4, and the 5 chord with our little walk down. Now let's get into playing this together. All right, so a little review of the strumming pattern that we've been using throughout this series here, which is down, mute, up, up, mute, mute. So we'll use that strumming pattern again throughout this video. Every time that we do that pattern, it equals one time or one bar. If you're digging the sound of my uke, head over to allforuke.com/shop. You can have a Kala ukulele for yourself. When you buy your Kala ukulele through All For Uke, you're supporting us and we really appreciate it. Make sure you check it out. Concerts, sopranos, tenors, baritones, a wide selection of accessories, capos, and more. All For You, allforuke.com/shop. All right, so now I'm gonna walk you through the 12 bar form. I'm just gonna demonstrate the minor blues and then we're gonna play it together. 1, 2, 3, 4, the 1, 2, the 4, back to 1, 1, 2, the 4, 4, and
walk down and then turn around. So we'll do that a little slower in first position here for our first play along. And the second play along, we're gonna move up into the higher register to challenge yourself a little bit and using a little bit more of the neck. All right, here we go with the metronome. We're gonna do this at 105. So try to stay with me. If you need to rewind this and do it a few times, feel free to do so. It's gonna be a lot of fun. So here we go. One, two, three, four. Down into the turnaround again, one to the four, back to one to the four, four, and back to one. Here we go to the walk down. So now we're going to take it up into the higher position for this play along. So again, E minor, A minor, and B minor chords here. So here we go, a little more tempo, 120 beats per minute. Woo, here we go. One, two, three, four. Walk down, back to one, again, one, to the four, and back to one, and to the four, four, and back to one. Here comes the walk down. Time, one, to the four, and back to one, to the four, and back to one, to the five, and turn it around. Well, thanks so much for joining me for our Let's Play Blues Together series. The baritone is a great place to play the blues, so I encourage you, try these different forms, try a few different keys other than the ones we've done. Make sure you grab the worksheet for this. This is a lot of fun to play. Let me know, where are you playing the blues around the world? Do you have a baritone? What kind of baritone are you playing? I want to know. I want to hear from you. My name is Kevin. I thank you so much for joining me for this series, and I'll see you next time. Let's get carried away.